What's going on, guys? Casual Savage here, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to reduce your video file size. Now in this video I'm going to be showing you a 3.2 gigabyte file converted down into a 2 gigabyte file. Now bear in mind, even though there is a big reduction in terms of gigabyte, there is no quality loss. Now I will be showing you an example of it later in the video, but now let's get to it. Now for those that don't already have Handbrake, I'll just show you where to download it from. If you already have Handbrake, you can skip forward to the time shown on screen now. Handbrake is 100% free. I've used it for many, many years, and this is their website. It is super simple to download. Head over to the website and select Download Handbrake. As you can see, this is for Windows 7, 8.1, and also 10. If you're on other platforms, click Other Platforms. As you can see, it is available on Mac. It's also available on Linux. So all you need to do is download which one is suitable for your operating system. Once you open up Handbrake, this is what it will look like. It is a very, very basic layout. Now the first thing you want to do is select open source, then if you're going to have a file or a folder full of files that you want to reduce in file sizes, then you would select the top one. If you have a single video, simply select open a single video file. So I'm going to be using this footage right here, and as you can see it has 3.20 gigabytes and it's 28 minute footage in MP4. I'm going to double click it. Here you have previews of what's going on. I will blur it out simply because this is a client's video. And I probably don't have permission to actually show you what's happening in the video. However, I'll leave it at this one. So that just gives you a little preview of what's happening in the video. Now where it says presets, this is going to be the main thing. So mine is actually exported in 1080 and at 30 frames per second. If you want to reduce the file size even more, then I do recommend using 720, 30 frames per second. Simply because it won't actually make much of a difference, and I will show you that later on. So I'm going to select 720. Here we have the format option as an MP4 or an MKV. I recommend MP4. I also recommend you tick web optimized, and I also recommend you leave align AV start ticked. Now you can just run through here. As you can see, the dimensions, the source is 1920 by 1080, meaning the original file size is that, and we're reducing it to 1280 by 720. Other than that, everything else you can literally leave the same. When you head over to the video section, you then get control of how the quality will be. This, to be honest, again, does not make much difference. I'll put it up, say, about here. You don't need to go completely full if you want to reduce the file size, because you won't really notice much of a difference in terms of the overall quality. Again, you can choose here the optimizing the video if you want it to encode faster, if you're in a rush and you need to get it done quickly. Of course, just put it very fast. But it's completely optional how you want this. Again, I don't even recommend to change it. Then you get control of the audio. If you choose to change it, probably not. If you have subtitles, you can just add in your SRT file right here. Then you have chapters. Again, not going to be necessary. So the final thing you need to do where it says save as is select browse. Now I'm going to save mine on my desktop again, and I'll just put in here reduced in all capitals so we know it's the reduced one. I'm going to select save. Now we're good to go. All we need to do is select start encode. This is now going to begin to encode and of course reduce your file size. At the bottom it will give you a time remaining. To be honest, I don't always trust that because it turns out to be quicker than what it displays. A great thing about this software, if you're going to be doing this overnight, say you have a huge file size and you want to do it overnight so you can literally use your computer while a file size is being reduced, then at the bottom right here you can see when done, you can set up actions. So that means when this encoding has been completed and the video is converted, you can then choose either do nothing, you can have your computer shut down, you can suspend, you can hibernate, you can lock the system, you can log off, or you can just make it simply quit Handbrake. So these are some pretty good options for you to choose, and of course make sure you do take advantage of it if you're doing it overnight. Now this is saying it's going to be taking around an hour, so what I'm going to do is leave this on and I'll get back to you when it is done. Okay, so we're back. As you can see, it is finished exporting And I think it probably took about 25 minutes. And you did see at the beginning when the estimated time was going up, it said about an hour. So you can see, don't trust the time remaining. Actually, just let it do its thing. Anyway, it's completed. It's up here, as you can see. And it is now 2 gigabytes. Now, bear in mind, if I just go back to the original file, the original file was 3 gigabytes and 20. This is now 2 gigabytes. So it's a good reduction we've had there. And bear in mind, it is a 28 minute video. It's still in HD. It's just not 1920 by 1080. It's now 720. However, like I said, I can't show you this video because it is a client's video. I have looked through the video, and to be honest, it is literally the exact same. You cannot notice the quality difference. The video I showed you in the beginning is going to be a before and after, so you can decide if there's actually a quality difference in terms of before and after. But that's it for this video. Hopefully it has been useful for you. A link to Handbrake will be in the description. I definitely recommend you give it a try. If there's a different software you recommend to use, definitely do leave it in the comments below, because it will help others out as well. And as always, any tutorial that you want to see, just let me know in the comments and I'll get it done for you as soon as I can.